Very good morning to our resource person, Professor Gautam Kumar sir, and very good morning to dear students. It's a privilege to really have sir once again with us. He has got a very big profile, but to just read a gist of his achievements, he is working as an assistant professor at University Department of Teacher Education, Utkal University, Bhubaneswar. He is pursuing his PhD from Regional Institute of Education, Bhubaneswar. He is a Master of Science as well as Master of Education. He is a UGC Research Fellowship he is being awarded with. He has, to his credit, TET of Bihar and Jharkhand State. He is proficient in using ICT tools in education, WordPress and Moodle. His areas of specialization is mathematics as a pedagogy, ICT in education, inclusive education, educational philosophy. As far as academic engagement of sir is concerned, he is a resource person in training programs organized by Teacher Education and SCERT Odisha, that is Regional Institute of Education, on various themes. His research contributions are, he is a team member of PACN Minor Research Projects of NCERT. He has acted as a resource person in various PACN Minor Research Projects of NCERT since 2014, 6 years down the lane. He is a team member for textbook evaluation of West Bengal and Odisha. He has contributed in curriculum development, team of integrated BSc, BA, BEd for Regional Institute of Education, Bhubaneswar. He has contributed in DL Elementary Education Curriculum for Jharkhand. He is a team member for BEd Curriculum Development for Jharkhand State. To his publications, he has 3 research papers in reputed journals. He has participated in national and international conferences, seminars, workshops, and he is even innovative in engaging learners in learning and evaluation through use of different ICT tools. He has hosted WordPress and Moodle website for engaging learner in the blended environment. So, we on behalf of Gujarat Research Society's Hansraj Jeevandas College of Education, our principal Dr. Anita Swami, faculty and all our loving students, we welcome you sir to this session on our Ek Bharat Shresth Bharat Club activity, and we begin with your talk. Welcome you sir.
Thank you madam.
Sir, I make you the host now, sir, okay, so okay, that you okay, can okay. So you can start, and by that time I'll be
okay. Okay, sure ma'am. First of all, sir, welcome all the students, faculty member, to this program, and I would like to thank you Dr. Srima Banerjee for inviting me in such a nice interactive program. I will also like to thank the Hansraj Jeevandas Society, Gujarat Society, and the principal of this college, and the all staff member for organizing such a nice program from time to time, because when we talk about the education, it is always, we used to say that it is beyond the content we used to learn in the textbook, but the main thing comes that how we take it beyond. Taking it beyond is the main thing, and these all program that we are using from organizing from time to time is actually the initiative, one steps to bring out the education out of the textbook, out of the four walls, like that. So I really appreciate madam your effort, because I see that always Srima Banerjee ma'am is engaged in organizing all those kind of activity, and I accept here that once upon a time I was also a student in one of the program organized by the madam. It was organized with in collaboration with the IIT Bombay, I am remembering, and it was on the GeoGebra. Okay, so I used to explore the different things that are very relevant for the teaching learning profession, and whatever the ICT tools and all the other things that I have learned, it is self explored by me through the Google or through the YouTube lecture and the video. Even the kind of a website I have hosted, all the coding I have learned through the YouTube. I have never learned coding, and I have never studied in the engineering. So I am a purely mathematician. I have MSc in mathematics, and then I have came to education and become the philosopher and pedagogue. So that's the tragedy. And cyber side, I have some interest in those area. That's why I have explored those things. So welcome once again, and I think now we can start our main point of discussion. Okay, so today we are going to discuss about the traditional ethos of Orisha. One minute. Traditional ethos of Orisha. What are the tradition of Orisha? What are the traditional practices of Orisha? Like kind of a thing we will explore. In the previous session that I have taken some time back, I have already emphasized that Orisha is such a culturally diverse, and the people here are the lovers of the art and a culture. People used to love art and a culture. They have a tradition. By birth, I am from the Bihar. But when you will go to the Bihar, it is not like that I am trying to highlight some state and trying to show that some state is less like that. But when you will go to the Bihar, we don't have a tradition of art, culture, dance, music, drama. We don't have a culture like that. But when you will come to the Orisha, you will find that the people are actually lover of the art and a culture. They have a rich heritage of those cultural tradition, and in that sense, when you see the Orisha is a unique kind of a state in the India. Okay, these are the outlook that I will be discussing. So I will not much focus here because it will be coming in some time. So why I am saying that they used to love the different kind of a dance, drama, music, art, craft. The one of the thing you will find that the earlier name of Orisha, the region, geographical location where the Orisha is existing as a state, Indian state, it was named as a Utkal. Sometime behind, before the Utkal, it was a Kalinga. I think you must have heard of the Kalinga war, the great war of the Ashoka. And after that war, Ashoka has seen that so many blood and so many sacrifices he seen, and then he thought all those things are the useless thing. The main thing is that there should be peace in the human's life, and then he turned into the Buddhist. So but after that the Kalinga, the name of the geographical location of Orisha was Utkal, and which literally means the land of excellence in the art. The literary meaning of Utkal is the land of excellence in the art. And when we see the history of Orisha, you will find the name Kalinga, even the Utkal, even in the Mahabharata times, means the literature available during at that time, you will find, you can trace the name. So we can understand that the existence of the people in this geographical location was even at that time. And after that, that is the ancient period. When you will go back to the 261 BCE, that is the time of the Ashoka of the Mauryan dynasty, you will find that at that time that I was talking about, that the Kalinga war, actually that the geographical location where the Kalinga war was fought is in the Bhuvaneswar, on the bank of a river Daya. And there is a one Santi Stupa also, and that is the place of the tourist attraction. Okay, and even after the even after that, when we see that the history of Orisha, you will find that during the British's time, it has got the separate state on the basis of the language. So language was the main basis of the separation of the state. Otherwise, it was a part of the Bengal. So that is the brief history of Orissa. Orissa is such a culturally diverse state. If I will start talking in a very detail, it will be very long. So just I am briefly introducing the different aspect of the Orissa state. And when we are talking about the Orissa, the talk will never end if we won't talk about the different festival, and the festivals are very much unique. You won't find similar parallel kind of a festival in the other part of India. Why I am saying, when I will discuss one by one, two, three festivals only I have taken, so you will realize. Suppose that I am talking about the Durga Puja. It is celebrated all over the India, in more or less somewhere like West Bengal, in the Jharkhand and Orissa also, we celebrate. But in some part of the country, they don't celebrate at that much devotion. So there may be variation, but people used to celebrate. But when we talk about the specific festivals of Orissa, it is only celebrated in the Orissa. Like that, when we talk about the Chhath Puja of Bihar, it is basically the festival of Bihar. So like that, the first one of the very famous festival of Orissa is the Rath Yatra. And Rath Yatra is the festival when the Lord Jagannath, Jagannath means Jagat Ka Nath, means he is the Lord of the universe, Jagat. So Jagannath is said to be the Lord of the universe. And the Jagannath is nothing but one of the different kind of Lord Krishna. Okay, so during that time, Jagannath's sister Devi Subhadra and brother Lord Balbhadra, both three, all the three are going to I forget the name. They used to go to the their Jagannath's aunt house. They go to they visit the Jagannath's aunt house, and then they return. Okay, and the festival is conducted in the total of 9 days, means one day of going, one day of returning. Going yatra is termed as a Rath Jatra, whereas the returning jatra is a term as a Bahuda Jatra. Okay, so these 2 days and 7 days of the stay, and they have their own Raths, means the Rath for the Jagannath, Balbhadra and the Subhadra. The Rath for the Jagannath is known as the Nandi Ghosh, Balabhadra's Rath is known as the Taladhwaja, and the Subhadra Rath is known as the Dwar Dalan. So these are the different three of Rath, and they visit, and they actually used to see that how their people are living in the world, because he is said to be the Lord of the universe. So he has a duty to see that how the people are staying, and it is celebrated generally when we see the Gregorian calendar. It occurs in the month of June or July, and when we see the Oriya calendar, it comes in the second day of the Shukla Paksha of Ashadh month. Okay, so Shukla Paksha Ashadh month, in that day it starts. So that is this is the another I think you must be able to see this photo. This is the very unique festival of the Orisha, very unique in this sense. Okay, you must be seeing in the photo that some girl is swinging on the swing and they are smiling. Okay, this is the festival related to the worshipping the Bhudevi. Bhudevi means the Mother Earth, and Mother Earth is also known as the Basumati, that is the wife of Lord Vishnu. Okay, so this is the festival of worshipping the Bhudevi, that is the Mother Earth, who is the wife of Lord Vishnu. And it is said that this is the 3 days festival. One first day is the Pahila Raja. The festival name is the, actually in the English we used to write Raja, R-A-J-A, Raja, but in Oriya we pronounce it Raja. As I was saying before, that in Oriya the pronunciation is like a O, so Raja we used to pronounce. This is the 3 day festival, and the first day is known as the Pahila Raja, then the Raja, and then the Basi Raja. So this is the 3 days, and it is said that during this time the Mother Earth is in the menstrual period, so all the girls will not be bother about any kind of a work. They will enjoy, they will dress up with a new dress, they will go for the roaming with the friends, and like that they will enjoy. And since it is believed that the Mother Earth is in the menstrual period, that's why there will be no activity related to the agriculture. No one will go to the agriculture field, and even they will not plug a single grass from the ground. Okay, because that is the time. And it is said that after that the Mother Earth becomes the fertile, and since the Mother Earth is fertile, so it is a time for the new agricultural season. And when we see that this is the time when the rain starts in the Orisha, so see how beautifully logically organized this kind of a festival in Orisha. And you won't find this kind of a festival in other part of a country, because we know that it's the menstrual period and all those things is a kind of a taboo kind of a thing in other point other part of India. I mean, when I remember my own state Bihar, we cannot talk openly on this type of a topic in the village. But Orisha has a tradition of worshipping not only the Mother Earth but also to the women and the girl child, and they will take a full rest for the 3 days, and after that the rain starts. During that season rain starts, and it is supposed that the Mother Earth get fertile and the agriculture process will start. So and when you will see the Raja word, actually it comes from the Sanskrit Rajas, which means the menstruation. So this is the festival of celebrating the fertility of land, fertility of the womanhood kind of a thing. And it starts in the Mithun Sankrantri, and the first day is also celebrated as a Mithun Sankrantri. Like that when the sun goes from one what to say that when the sun moves from then sun goes to the different kind of Sankranti. So I think in the Orisha we have a 11 to 12 kind of a Sankranti, means almost every month you will observe a Sankranti kind of a thing. Okay, so this is observed, means starts on the first day of a Mithun Sankranti, and from that day Mithun Sankranti months also starts and the agriculture work also starts. So this is the very unique kind of a festival in the Orisha. Till now I have not seen this kind of a festival in other part of a country. If you have during the discussion session, you can also add me. As I was telling that first day is the Pahila Raja, and that the last day is known as the Basi Raja. So like that I have. Then another festival is that the Bali Jatra, and this festival is also known as the boat festival, and it is a very culturally linked to the life of a people of Orisha, because in the early days people of the Orisha were visiting to Bali, Sumatra, Sri Lanka, Bonero, like even Java for the trade purposes. Okay, so for the trade purposes they were going and they were visiting, and they have, when they have started first to visit Bali, Sumatra, Sri Lanka, and they started traveling that much of a long distance, then for the betterment of the persons, those who are traveling in the boat, because at that time the women were staying in the house and the male person were going in the boat for the trade purpose. So what was happening, the girl, women means the wife of the person who is traveling, they were sitting in the house and they were lighting the lamp, and they were praying in front of the lamp for the betterment of the person, those who are going, and till they will return, the women in the shift wise, they will be sitting in front of the light and they will be praying, and the light will not go off. If it will go off, it means that there is some damage to their boat. So this is the starting point of this festival, and in this during this festival, nowadays the people used to sail the artificial boat in the river or in the pond, and pray for the betterment of the family, because nowadays they are not going, all the family members are not going for the fishing or the trading through the boats. Even now the trade is not happening through the boats, if nowadays it is happening through the big ship, but the tradition is there, and during that time you will find there is a very big mela will be organized in the Cuttack, that is known as the Bali Jatra, and this is known as the boat festival. And one more word I have written, that is the Boli Bandhana, means the nowadays the rituals which we do, that preparing artificial boat and sailing it to the rivers and the pond. So that is known as the boat Bandhana. Aap isko padhenge, when you will read, we used to say that a boat, but you will find that here I have written boita, because it is pronounced in Oriya like that, boita. Boita Bandhana, aise pronounce karte hain. Now come to the cultural heritage, cultural even the diversity in the art and craft. You will find that the Utkal region, that the Orisha, is a very rich in the art and craft. You will find the varieties of art and craft in the Orisha region, ranging from the bamboo craft, ranging from the silk textile, ranging from the dokra, ranging from the clay toys. And the very unique thing in the Orisha, what I find, that when you will move from one district to another district, every district they will have a speciality in the sweet, they will have a specialty in the art and craft, okay, and they will have also a specialty in their cultural practices. Even our neighbor district, that is the Cuttack, which is only 20 kilometer far from the capital city Bhubaneswar, culturally it is a different, okay. So before this class I was talking to the madam and she was saying that when they were going to the Puri, they have visited the Pipli, and Pipli is a very famous for the applique work. Excellent applique work you will find there. Even when you will go to the Cuttack, Cuttack is known as the silver city of Orisha, and you will find a lots of silver work in the Cuttack. Even in the Cuttack you will find the Ikat Sari. Okay, so lot of handicraft and art is there in the Orisha. You must be seeing that this is the picture. This is picture of the Pattachitra, and Pattachitra is the speciality of the Raghurajpur Puri. It is the village near the Puri. It is a small village, and the speciality of this kind of a chitra is that you might be finding that what is the speciality. The first speciality is that it is handmade. Even the paper on which it is made, it is also handmade, and the color which is used here, it is also pure natural color, no synthetic. So you won't find any synthetic things in this Pattachitra. So color is natural, paper is handmade, drawing is by hand. Even, and they used to prepare the color from the different flowers and the leaves, and okay, like that they used to prepare the colors. And this is the very special kind of a painting from the Orisha. You must be seeing this, and this is the one of the speciality of the Orisha, which is made in the Mayurbhanj. It is made of the horn. You must have seen the cattle. A cattle have the horn like that on the head. This is made from the that horn. This kind of a beautiful art you will find here. And see, this is the palm leaf drawing. It is drawn on the palm leaf. It is neither paper or neither cloth, nothing. It's a drawn on the palm leaf, and the color used here is not you will not find a variety of a color on the palm leaf drawing. You will find that the red, black, blue kind of a drawing only you will find, and it will be not a very much colorful like that. When we were seeing that the Pattachitra, that was very much colorful, but you won't find that variety here. But it is also purely handmade, no chemical at all, and this is known as the Tassar Patta. That was the Pattachitra, and this is the Tassar Patta. The basic difference here is that there we were using the handmade paper for making the Pattachitra, but here we are using the Tassar silk. I think you must be knowing the Tassar silk. Tassar silk is the very fine silk. So the pictures are drawn on the Tassar silk cloth. Okay, and this is the Santhal painting. You must be knowing that Orisha is a such a culturally diverse state, where you will find the Brahminism culture, you will find that the tribal culture, you will even find the scheduled tribes, they have their own culture. You will find that there is a variety in the tribal culture. When you will go to the Sambalpuri culture is entirely different. They have a different kind of a clothing, they have a different step of a dancing, they have even the different language, Sambalpuri language. Their way of living is entirely different than the other part of our Orisha. Okay, so that is the beauty, and this is the Santhal painting, is from the Santhal region of the Orisha. They used to paint like that, and this is the famous work of the Pipli that I was talking just few time back. So I think sorry for the interruption, it's a technical glitch, it used to happen. So I was talking about the aplik work. It is a speciality of the Pipli village. It's a very small village, but very culturally rich, and they have the very fine skill of making the Pipli kind of item. You will find lots of variety and lots of design when you will visit the Pipli. And this is the silver filigree work, and this is the speciality of the Cuttack. A lot of variety of silver work you will find in the Cuttack, and that's why the Cuttack is known as the silver city of Orissa. It is also a part of a twin city of Orissa. Bhuneshwar and Cuttack both are known as the twin city. Okay, so this is the speciality of the and this is the sand art. You must be knowing that the Sudarshan Patnaik, he is from Orissa and he is the well known sand artist. He used to prepare the sand art on the different topic. Okay, and as the Orissa is very much well known for the art and artifact and the culture, Orissa textile industry is also very famous. And some of you may be knowing or some of you may not be knowing that even the Indira Gandhi, even the Sonia Gandhi, even the Priyanka, even the Sushma Swaraj, okay, all of them were very fond of the Orissi sari. And it is said that during her life, means Indira Gandhi, in her life she has never worn any sari except the sari from the Orissa. Sari from the Orissa was going for the Indira Gandhi. And so many politicians, so many even the actors, well known figures, they used to prefer the wear the Orissa Odia sari. It is bit costly because it is not prepared on the machine. It is prepared on the hand loom, means handmade sari. Even what kind of a design we used to say, that is the handmade. Even if it is a printed sari, it is a hand printed. So that's why it becomes a little bit costly. And when we see that the silk sari of the not only sari, even the cloth of the Orissa, you will find that there is a lot of variety, and the variety is entirely different from the other part of a country. Okay, you must be seeing that one picture I am showing here. One lady is weaving sari. Okay, so all the sari is the hand woven, and they have a lot of variety within the cloth also. When you will, as I was saying, that every district have their own speciality. They have a speciality in the food, they have a speciality in the cultural practices, even the dance drama, even that the festival, even the clothing. When you will go to the Koraput, you will find that the Kotpad sari and the Kotpad cloth. Kotpad cloth is found in both the silk and the cotton. In the both variety you can get it, that is the Kotpad cloth. And when you will go to the Sambalpur, you will find the Sambalpuri sari. When you will go to the Kala Handi, you will go to the Hansabani Puri. When you will go to the Burger, you will find the Sakatpur or Pasapalli. When you will go to the Ragada and the Kala Handi, you will also find the Dogri. When you will and the Bomkai and the Sonpuri is woven all over the Orissa. It is a different kind of it will have a different kind of a texture. So we identify the Bomkai and Sonpuri with the texture. When you will go to the Berhampur, you will find the Berhampuri cloth. So there is a variety of cloths, and the textile industries are available, but it is not woven on the machines. It is all hand prepared. It is prepared in the hand looms, and these cloths are very much fine, very comfortable, and very good. And like that, I have tried to touch almost all part of the culture. When we talk about the cultural practices, it starts from the festival, with the fooding habit, with the dance, drama, like that everything it includes. So another part in that the cultural ethos of the Orissa is the music and a dance. When you will see that the Orissi music is a little bit different from the other music that is available in the other part of a country. It is more closely related to the Carnatic music and the Hindustani music. Hindustani music is the widely available all over the India, but it is not very much directly replica or the directly very much linked with the Hindustani music, but it is influenced, but it has a different kind of a different kind of the notes, that the rhythm and raga in the Orissi music. It's a kind of a, it comes under the classical style of a music, but when you will go to the literature of the musical literature, I am not very much efficient in those area, but I was talking with some people. They used to say that there are controversy in that. Means some expert, they think that it is a part of the classical style of a music, but some don't believe in that. Some of them are not agree. So let it be the point of controversy aside, but we will talk about that, what is the widely acceptable. It is supposed that the Orissi music is the classical style of a music, and that comprises the essential element such as the taal, raga, comma, to the Carnatic and Hindustani music. Okay, and when we talk that when this kind of a music started in the Orissa, it is traced back to the Jayadeva, who is said to be the first Oriya poet who composed the musical lyrics. Okay, it is said that. And when we talk about the Orissa Sangeet, it is a combination of the four classes of a music. That is the Chitrakala, Chitrapada, Dhrubapada and Panchal. I am not very expert in the music, so I won't be able to explain much even that when the question of music will come. I won't be able to explain beyond that. But Orissi Sangeet is a combination of the Chitrakala, Chitrapada, Dhrubapada and the Panchal. And the main rag in the Orissi Sangeet are the Bhairavi. I think it's a very famous rag, and the Baradi, Dhanasri, Kalyan, Karnata, Nata, Panchama, Srigoda and Shoka Baradi. So these are the famous main rag in the Orissi Sangeet. And when we come to the music and dance, obviously, so one of the famous dance from the Orissa is the Orissi, which is not only famous throughout the India but throughout the world. It is the one of the famous dance all over the world. And when we see that how this dance has originated, how come into the existence, actually the tradition of a music and the dance was in the temples culture. Means the people were going to the temple, they were and when you will go to the when you will see the temples in the Orissa, you will find that you will have one entrance gate, then you will have a small that is the hall kind of a thing, and then that is known as the prayer hall, and then you will find that there is a big hall that is known as the dance hall. Okay, so this is the structure you will find when you will see the temples in Orissa. Even I was seeing the sketch of the Ram Mandir, that is which is the proposed, it also have a prayer hall and a dance hall. So this was the kind of a structure in the ancient temple of India. So the main function of a dance hall was that the girls and ladies were coming and they were performing the dance. And from the temple culture, the Orishi and the other kind of not other kind of a dance, the Orishi dance and the other musical music has emerged and it has been rooted to the culture of Orisha, and it has been it has a very great place in the Orishi culture. You will find that the parents will motivate the girl, even the male child, that is the boy, to learn the Orishi dance. I remember that I have so many friends who are very proficient in the Orishi dance, not girl, even the boy, they are very proficient in the Orishi dance because it's a very cultural heritage of the Orisha. And this is the one of the dance from the Orisha which is known as the Medha Nacha. Here the dancer used to wear a mask, okay, and they perform the mask by wearing the they perform the dance by wearing the mask. And this is the basically the dance from the Puri at that time. Puri, from this dance belongs from the Puri. And one more thing I have not included previously, actually I have not forgotten, because so many of a thing is that how many thing I will inculcate. So include, when I was talking about the art, there is another art which is known as the mask art, that is the basically from the Puri. They used to prepare the different kind of a mask, okay. So that is the unique kind of art from the Puri. Okay, so in the Medha Nacha, the dancer used to wear a costume with a mask, okay, and the mask will be oversized of a queen or a devil, or sometime of a even the cattle's lion like kind of a thing, and they will wear the mask and then they will dance. That is the Medha Nacha. And this is the dance from the tribal belt, because the western part of Orissa is a tribal dominated location. And this is the kind of you cannot term, because when I see this kind of a dance, I have seen, but I have not seen in the Orissa. I have seen this kind of a practice in the Jharkhand when I was in the Ranchi. Okay, so because the Jharkhand and Orissa is the adjacent state, so the adjacent part have a same kind of a cultural practices, especially when we talk about the tribals. So here they used to worship the Lord Shiva, they used to praise the Lord Shiva, and they undergo, they will walk on the very sharp edged object, they will walk in the red charcoals, means the burning red charcoals, like kind of a rituals and the activity they used to perform. And by these all kind of a thing, they praise the Lord Shiva. And basically when we talk about the Orisha, I was talking about the Ranchi and the Jharkhand, so I was speaking. So when we talk about the Orisha, basically this kind of activity is performed in the Ganjam district, okay, that is known as the Danda Nacha. I think you must be able to resemble, because Danda, the word Danda in Uriya has come up with the word Dand. Dand in the Hindi, Dand means punish, okay. So they used to punish themselves and they praise the God that whatever the wrong thing, whatever the bad thing I have done, so I am punishing myself, please forgive all those things. And like that they used to praise the Lord Shiva. So this is the tradition of the Ganjam district. And this is the Goita Ghoda. It is a nothing, but it is the very common type of a dance, and it is available in I think almost all part of the country, where some person will be wearing the costume of the horse and they will be dancing, and it will be accompanied with the two person. One will be the playing some instrument and one will be singing. So in total minimum 3% is required for that, because one will be singing, one will be playing the instrument, and one will be dancing, minimum. Okay, so that is that. And see, this is the very much vibrant dance of the Orisha, that is known as the Sambalpuri. I think you must be able to identify with the clear picture and a good picture, because when I was searching in the internet, I got the good picture of the Sambalpuri dance in the good resolution. Picture resolution of a picture is a very good. And the culture of a Sambalpuri is entirely different. They have a different kind of dancing style, even the language, everything is a different for them. You must be have seeing that the costume of the dancers, and they have a different steps also. That type of a step you won't find in the other dance. In fact, the classical and a traditional dance have the unique kind of a step. In fact, it is that. So it is traditionally during this dance, drum, timki, nisan kind of a thing. It is a drum. You must be able to see that is a drum. This kind of a instrument was being played, but nowadays people used to dance on the Sambalpuri music also. They used to dance. And when we talk about the Orisha, the story of Orisha will never end without the discussion on the temples. You must be knowing that the Bhuneswar itself is known as the temple city of India. It is a temple city. Means in any part of Bhuneswar you go, you will find one temple, minimum one. One means not a single, minimum. Where I am staying, when I see this side with the temple hai, every side I have a temple, 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 sab taraf temple hai. You will find a lot of a temple in the Bhuneswar. And whenever you will see the Orisha as a whole, you will find a so many of ancient temple in each corner of the Orisha, each corner. And they are not newly built. It is not like that it is a newly built. In the Bhuneswar you will find the newly built temple, because where I am staying, it is the newly established residential colony by the BDA, that is Bhuneswar Development Authority. But when you will see the Orisha, you will find a lot of ancient temple. One of the very famous temple, which is one of the four dham of Hindus, is the Jagannath temple, which is in the Puri. And it is said that it was started rebuilding in the 10th century by the king Anant Varman. He was the first king of the Ganga destiny. Okay, he was the first king. And you will find that the uniqueness of this temple is, there are lot of uniqueness you must find on the internet, that you won't find the shadow of the dom. When you will see the Neela Chakra, I mean the chakra of the because the Jagannath is nothing but the Vishnu, so chakra is there. So when you will see the chakra, you will find that it is facing towards you, whatever the direction is that. When you will be outside the temple, you will able to listen the sound of a sea. But when you will go to the temple, you won't listen the sound of a sea. Lots of things are there, but some other thing I will discuss, which is not easily available. It is not like that it is not available, but easily.
Sir, sorry to interrupt, but only two.
This is the second last slide, ma'am.
Okay,
ma'am. So I will be hurry in the finishing first. Okay, no problem, ma'am. So one of the unique thing is that when you will go to the other temple, you will find that the idol, that is the statue of the god, is either in of the stone or of the metal. But here the god is made of the wood. It is made of the wood. And in every 12 or 19 year, the exact replica of the god statue is replaced. And that is known as the Nabkalevar. Nab Kaleber process. This is the one year long duration process, and this is the Nab Kaleber. And during that time, all the good activities, that the holy activity like a opening of a house or a marriage, will be suspended in the entire Orisha. So this is the one of the. This is the temple of Ma Tarini temple, and it is in the Ghatgaon. Place name is the Ghatgaon, and it is the Keonjhar district of Orisha. That is the one of the very old and famous temple, and you can find trace the history of this temple to the Ramayana event. Can be traced. You can search in the internet. And this is the Konark temple. You think you must be knowing. It was built by the Eastern Ganga Destiny in the 1250 CE by the King Narasimha Dev. But now it is damaged, and there is no worship of the god is happening in the temple because it is damaged. We don't worship the damaged idol, statue, or the temple. So for the visiting purpose only we used to go. It is the sun temple, and the temple is built on the carrot. Okay, so like that. And this is the last one. It is the one of the oldest temple of the Bhuvaneswar. That is the Lingaraj temple, and the god here is the Lord Shiva. It is devoted to the Lord Shiva. So it is the one of the oldest temple of the Bhuvaneswar. So now I can say that thank you for the patienceful listening. And I was talking. I don't know that how much time is left. But whatever the time is left, already I have crossed the time. Okay. So, ma'am, is there any scope of the question answer session? Otherwise, if
sir,
it is not possible.
Sir, I think it is a little difficult. Student, any questions?
Okay,
student, any questions? One question. We can take one question that has come
any
to your mind. That has come to your mind.
Or they can email me, I will
okay,
reply
fine.
Each email.
Okay, yes. Okay.
I will share
okay.
My.
You put the questions on the chat box, we will take it
from
here.
And,
or you put it on the WhatsApp
group. You can always forward
okay,
it to
okay.
Always forward it to sir.
Okay. Sure.
Half a minute
for a very important part.
Very important part.
Sir,
good afternoon to all.
Good afternoon to all.
And on behalf of our management, Anita Swami, Madam staff and madam
staff, and
I express a heartfelt gratitude
for the lovely
presentation on festivals,
art and craft,
the music
and
dance forms of
Odisha. And
you spoke about Rajoparab, Bhojatra,
significance
given to the girl child
in the
Odisha culture,
historical places
like Kerala, 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 Ker